miss you like a whole lot. I started smoking pot, trying to ease the pain, but it's hard when it's raining outside. I'm going out my mind, I'm tripping. It's hard for me to forget about the one that I'm missing. We was just laughing, kissing, fuck, keep reminiscing. And you ain't called me up like one time, which tells me that you must be doing just fine. I wanna hit you up, but I'll be wasting my time. Why I lie to myself? Sometimes I wanna cry to myself, I wanna talk, but you was the one I went to for the help. I wanna walk, but I ain't used to walking by myself. This shit sucks. Got me thinking that you found somebody else, and I wanted to be your one and only. Now I'm at this restaurant all by my lonely. You fucking fake bitch, damn, you so fucking phony. But I'd pick up if you just decide to call me just once. Like, and I stop calling and you stop calling. Will I reminisce over you, my God? It's when I stop calling and you stop calling. Will I reminisce over you, my God? It's when I stop calling and you stop calling. Will I reminisce over you, my God? It's when I stop calling and you stop calling. Will I reminisce over you, my God?
Please don't turn me off.
Listening to the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network, Woman Wednesday. Shouts out to all of the ladies on Woman Wednesday. This is the Doug Stewart Show. Braves go down yesterday to the Giants, 6-3. I'm looking at the Braves record right now. And you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Looking at the Braves record right now, man. Did you realize that the Braves, with all of the angst that we thought we'd have this year with this team and rebuilding and new manager and Brian Snicker, that the Braves are in second place in the NL East? That's right. They're 10.5 games behind the Washington Nationals, who got real pitching issues themselves. But the Braves are in second. I mean, the Miami Marlins, 5-5 in their last 10. The Mets, 4-6 in their last 10. And the Philadelphia Phillies, they just need to shut down the darn organization for the rest of the year. They're 1-9 in their last 10 games, but as much as the Braves have struggled this year, man, they're almost playing 500 baseball. They're 10.5 games back once again from Washington, but they're 5-5 in their last 10. They're expecting to bring back, or were expecting to bring back, Bartolo Colon off the 10-day DL, but they announced that dude's got some stiffness in his back. You would be too. You would have stiffness in your back too, if you're 44 years of age and, not the guy, the athlete that you once were. So rookie left-handed pitcher Sean Newcomb, 0-2, 2.19 ERA, the young kid that they pulled up from Gwinnett, will move up to take his regular turn in the rotation next game out for the Atlanta Braves. So that's a little Braves talk for you. 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug, thedougstewartshow.com. Let me jump in the chat room on Spreaker.com. Sensational says, so OJ is not from South Carolina? No, OJ Simpson's not from South Carolina, sir. Everybody's not from South Carolina, but when I say they're from South Carolina, give South Carolina some respect. Let South Carolina breathe, okay? We got famous people, too. We got famous people, too. OJ is not from South Carolina, so you're trying to be funny. Now, the great Teddy Pendergrass is from South Carolina. Sydney Jackson says, Evander Holyfield's head is wider than his shoulders. Evander got a head on him, too, but he don't want none of O.J. Simpson. Nah, it's a different class. It's a different class of big-ass heads. From Clay Ball, LeBron Davis, he says, O.J. versus HGH Peyton Manning for the head-butting championship of the world. Ooh. Yeah, Peyton got a noggin on him, too. It's hard to judge if you don't see the person, if you don't see the actual head close up, if you're not in the same room with the person. Like my entire life, I went through life thinking that O.J. Simpson's head was of normal size for a male human being. But coming into contact with O.J. Simpson, I find out that that is not the case. You know how they say TV makes you look smaller? TV definitely makes your head look smaller, too. Because you can't really judge or get a grasp, an understanding of how big this man's noggin is. Yeah. From Sydney Jackson, it's time to let her go, bruh. She getting ran through by them hood ninjas. Who are you talking about? From Ralph Scott Mocha, you may have to change your Abby and let Doug know what time it was. Or it is. Woman Wednesday. Hmm. From Sandman, OJ told the investigation team, you want to search my home? Go ahead then. Oh, y'all funny. Y'all silly. From Sin, he says, ain't no woman in here but Mocha. From Big L, X Squad, where are the ladies at today? Yeah, where's, maybe they had things to do. No Tiffany Sports and Heels today. No Tiffany Pool in Portland. I know Tiffany Pool in Portland. She's got a lot of work to do. But hey, ladies, man, today is your day. Spread the word. Invite your lady friends to come in on Woman Wednesday. Come on. Come on now. Come on. Don't act like that. From Sydney Jackson, I watched part of that OJ Made in America. OJ's black wife always looked sad as hell in the video she was in. Yeah, she didn't look like she was having a good time. From Clay Ball, LeBron Davis, this is almost Hard Leg Wednesday, sister women. Hard Leg Wednesday. No, we're not going to call the show Hard Leg Wednesday. From Mr. Harper, VP of Ninjaville, Kaza, being in second and being below 500 means zero. They aren't competing for anything. From, who do we have here? LD, casting LBJ is just a normal size hoop or two until they see this ninjas in real life. Huh. From the People's Champ, Doug doesn't care about Women's Wednesday. That's a shame. What? How dare you, sir? How dare you? From Kaza, is this the last Women's Wednesday? No. Hell to the no. Woman Wednesday will live on forever. From Dobby, I'm not trying to talk about other dudes' heads. You see how you want to darn muddy the waters? Nobody talking about nothing like that, sir. Move on. From Cornelia Small, so was Teddy Pendergrass being a good guy, or was he caught being a boonky bandit? Much different story with Teddy Pendergrass and Eddie Murphy's story, I say. Especially him being from South Carolina. If you don't know what I'm talking about or what Cornelia Small is talking about, look up the story on Teddy Pendergrass and something that happened like 25 years ago. From James the Big Truck Driver, can we get a head counted? Slade says, what's Woman Wednesday? Oh, man. Woman Wednesday is a beautiful thing where every Wednesday we pay homage to the ladies all over the world. Long story short, there's a big misunderstanding between me and the female listeners to the Doug Stewart Show. And as a negotiation, we gave them their own day, and we call it Woman Wednesday. And it's funny, nobody else in America was doing Woman Wednesday on radio until we started doing it here. And now Jalen and Jacoby, what's it called? They got this podcast. And just magically, they started doing Woman Wednesday a couple of months back. I always tell y'all how the damn game works. They got people on staff to listen and kill and get and pull ideas from other shows all over America. They got this big budget, so they just steal and pillage everything they want. From Kaza. Kaza says, maybe the ladies are in the kitchen and the bedroom. The kitchen and the bedroom. No! Why would you say something like that, sir, on Woman Wednesday especially? How dare you? Ain't no freaking James Evans from Good Time. From Miss Mocha Bella. Hey, Mocha. Ignore what Kaza just said. Ignore that whole comment about the kitchen and the bedroom. The kitchen and the bedroom, Florida. Ignore that. Miss Mocha Bell says, Thorny traveling the West Coast. Check out our Instagram. Okay. So that's why Thorny isn't here today. One of our big supporters of the show. Thorny Switch. Long story on how she got her name as well. From Mr. Harper, Thorny is on vacation living her best life. Enjoy, Thorny. Okay. Thorny does need to listen, though, or take some time out of her day on her vacation to listen to the Doug Stewart Show on podcast. I'm saying, man, that's worthy of a BPA. I think I do need to give them a BPA. And talking about Jalen and Jacoby, I won't do that. You know what? I'm going to say the producers of Jalen and Jacoby. Me and Jalen Rose, you know, we kind of cool. We know each other's acquaintances. So I don't think that he stole this idea. I think it's the producers or whatever that stole the idea about Woman Wednesday and paying homage to women and changing your profile pics to beautiful women. Classy, not showing all of the ass. So I'm gonna put down here the producers of Jalen and Jacoby. Cats been pillaging our shit forever. I turned on damn SportsCenter when they first started with Jamil and Michael Smith, and they pumping up Public Freaking Enemy. Really, dude? Really? Really? You playing Public Enemy at the start of your intro onto your show? Huh? Really? So I'm pretty much used to it now. If you're new to the Doug Stewart Show, we give out Ball Penis Awards every Friday, where we give out a Buster Award for the week in sports, entertainment, and beyond. We call it the Ball Penis Awards. It's a long story on how we came up with the name. Just trust me, that's what it is. And so we take nominations all week, and we have an actual live poll that you can go and vote on Friday. The Doug Stewart Show, the Stewart Media and Entertainment Group Facebook chat group. So that's where that all comes from. So we got a couple of nominations already. Jalen and Jacoby's producers. Old Man Cuddy, Babs, Big African, and the Jungle Brother combined. Angry Black Man. Why did we nominate the Angry Black Man? He's so damn angry. A multitude of reasons, whatever. Grego saying that Jeff Fisher was right about Vince Young. Those are your nominees thus far. We got a couple more days to get a couple more. The Orange Dude is already nominated. That's just a weekly thing. So that's what happens on Friday. All right, so when we get back from the break, we'll wrap up today's show. Read a couple more messages in the chat. And knock off. Get on out of here today. This is the Doug Stewart Show. Don't go away. Stay right there.
Fucking fool, little nigga, I need mine. I mean, I'm supposed to keep the lights on. The baby's fit.
Yeah, but